Hey everybody, this is Nick, and I'm coming to you today with a really cool trick that was inspired by a colleague of mine, Joe Travers, over at Travers Data, and I want you to go and check out his site. I'm going to put the link below. He also has a really cool new resource called How to Use Power BI. He has both free and paid content, and I'm going to link to that one in the comments below, in the description below too. It is such a cool resource for anybody who is into Power BI, especially if you're just learning how to use Power BI. Joe makes everything so very user-friendly and easy, even for a novice like me. I haven't really explored too much into Power BI, but I know exactly who I'm going to go to when I'm ready. So Joe, thanks for this tip. He shared an Instagram reel with me on how to create some like moving backgrounds and how we might be able to do this in PowerPoint. So I know he has some pretty cool options on his end. Maybe he'll post them one of these days, but look at this really cool gradient moving background with some text that's really intersected in text. And we've done some of these techniques before in previous videos, and I'm gonna walk through how to make this exact slide kind of in just sort of your own custom fashion. So I'm gonna go ahead and escape out of this slide. And we're gonna go up to the top. First, I wanted to just show you sort of the bones and the behind the scenes of what we're doing here. Basically, I'm gonna create my own sort of moving gradient background with just a bunch of shapes. These are just some blob shapes that I sort of created in PowerPoint from circles. I have a kind of a transparent gradient rectangle over it in a different color. And we just used Morph on a bunch of slides, and we then exported that as a video. You can do that in PowerPoint. And then I imported that video back. I intersected some text on top of it using the merge shapes tools. And then I also put a stock photo behind it and added some transparency for a little bit of depth. So stick with me here. This one's gonna be a little bit long, but I'm gonna take you through how I made those first morph slides here. So we're gonna go over to a blank slide. And what I'm first gonna do is insert a circle. So I just gonna insert this circle here. I'm actually gonna click on Edit Points, and this is how I kind of create those sort of amorphous blobs. We have a video on that too. I'm just gonna duplicate that. We're gonna make these in different shapes here. You can do this, experiment with your own sort of look and feel and colors. I'm gonna make them a little bit bigger than I would normally, just because we're gonna end up making the edges of these shapes really soft. And so I'll show you what that does in a second. I'll do one more shape over here. We'll just kind of overlap them together. I'm actually going to make the background of my slide this sort of bright purple right here. Well, actually, I might actually make it maybe this really dark blue, shade of dark blue right there. That's kind of nice. Let's see, I'm gonna go up and change the colors of these just to a few different color shapes there. And let's see, maybe an orange. I think I want to swap that orange and blue. So let's see, I'm going to highlight all of them. And I'm going to go ahead over to the Format Shape menu, and under Soft Edges right here, I'm going to go ahead and just take that slider and really sort of blur them down like this. And then I can take everything and make them sort of even bigger. And you can just sort of play with this to your heart's content, I think. So I have this one slide right here. Now everything on my slide is the way I want to start this out. I'm going to duplicate this slide by pushing Control D, and then we're going to go ahead and just move the shapes around kind of in a no particular order. You can also change the size of them a little bit if you wanted to. And this is that morph technique there. All right, and now what I'm gonna do is apply the slide transition, go up to the transition tab here and apply morph, and you can see that it gives you a preview of what that slide is gonna do. You could set it to go slower or faster. Right now the duration is 2 seconds. Let's see, I'm gonna make it 5 seconds and see how that looks. All right, I'm liking that. Let's go ahead and duplicate this slide, and then I'll kind of move some things around again. Make them just sort of really amorphous. We'll move that, and we'll move that. And let's preview that and see what that looks like. Yeah, I think that looks pretty cool. Another thing then you might want to do is you can actually duplicate this first, we can actually duplicate this slide again, and then bring that on the other side of it. And then that'll show you how it's going to sort of move back and forth. And then I'm going to duplicate this slide. and put that on the end. So now let's go ahead and play this and see how it looks. Looks pretty cool there. Right now, my slides are set to move on a mouse click, so I'm gonna have to go back and just make sure that those are set to do something else, that they're set to advance on their own. All right, we'll escape out of that. I think that looks pretty good. You can see under the transitions tab over here on the timing, it says on mouse click. I'm gonna go ahead and click on after, and it's just going to make sure that it advances on its own. Now, the other thing we wanna do is perhaps apply that gradient background, that gradient background that I have here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and insert a rectangle. We're gonna make sure that it fills the entire slide. I don't want any outline on it. I don't really care if there is one, but I'm gonna go ahead and make this a gradient. And you can see I already used this gradient, that purple gradient, so this is a linear gradient. And then what I did on each of these stops, one of the sides is white and one of the sides is purple. And I just applied a very light transparency to each. The white side I have 25%, and the purple I have just 10%. So I think that's gonna look pretty good. I'm gonna copy this and I'm just gonna duplicate it on all of these slides so that it's on the top of everything. Now let's go ahead and play that morph again. Oops, let's make sure that this is set to after so that it advances on its own. And we're just gonna go ahead and you can see that it's creating this gradient background. Those blobs are kind of just moving in the background, and that's kind of an interesting effect all on its own. Now what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna make sure, I have a bunch of other slides in here for my demonstration, but I'm gonna make sure that these slides are hidden. So I'm just going to, they're already hidden, but I'm gonna show you. Just hold down shift, select them all, and then click on hide. You could unhide these, but these are already, if I unhide them, they'll come back to life. If I hide them, they'll be hidden. And then I wanna make sure that these other slides are hidden too. Those are my demonstration slides for the next part. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna export this as a video. So go to file, export this as video. Create a video. You can use the standard. If you wanted to spend more seconds on the slide, you could update that here. So just create the video. We're gonna go ahead and save it to our desktop. I'm gonna call this moving text, export it. It just takes a little bit of time for PowerPoint to do some thinking. And once, I'm gonna go ahead and unhide this slide. Once you're finished, once that video is finished exporting, what you're gonna be able to do is you're gonna be able to insert a video, and we'll insert a video from device. And I'm gonna go over to my desktop, wherever that is, and we wanted that moving text video right there, perfect. All right, so you can see this video here. It's an MP4 file. It just comes right into your slide. Now, on the video format tab and the playback tab, we're gonna go ahead and set the start, not in click sequence, but we're gonna make sure that this is set to automatically. That means that the video will play automatically there. I'm gonna go ahead and move this to the background. Now, I already have this text box here that I set up called moving background. You would update that to whatever text that you wanted. I'm gonna make sure that's in a nice place right there. And what we're gonna do, actually, I'll just make sure that's right in the center, use our align tools, be very good about that. And we're gonna highlight the video and highlight the text. And then you have to use merge shapes tools. Now the merge shapes tools do not automatically come up when you have a video. They do when you have a picture or other shapes, but video they don't. So I've added my merge shapes tools to my quick access toolbar, so they're always there. So now what I can do is click on that drop-down menu and click on intersect. And now that intersects the text and that video. And so now you can see when I push play, you can see the gradient background is moving within sort of that text, which is pretty cool. Now what I was gonna do is change the solid fill of the slide background to maybe this very dark blue. And then I had inserted a picture from stock photo. So insert a picture from stock images. I'm just gonna select this. I searched for purple abstract. I usually just type in abstract and you get all these cool shapes. This was the photo that I decided before. I'm gonna insert that. I wanna make sure this fills the entire background of the slide. So one trick that I use for that is our Bright Slide free add-in, PowerPoint add-in. I just click on the photo and click match size and it fills the slide with the photo and kind of in a crop fashion like that. Now we're gonna send that photo to the back. And I'm gonna make this photo just a little bit transparent. Let's actually go to maybe 60% transparency. And I like that now. Now, since the video is set to automatic play, oh, that video actually changed. So it says when clicked on, we wanna make sure that we start the video automatically. So make sure to click on that automatically. Now, when I play that slide, it should move perfectly. And let's see if that video moves. Yep, it looks like the video is moving in the background. It's a really, really cool effect. Now what you could do is export this one slide as a video, or you could export it as a GIF and you could post it on social media. But I think this would be a really cool effect to use for a slide, you know, if you're doing a workshop or some other training, as people are coming into the room, maybe it's your branding, maybe it's your company name, and you just have a little bit of extra movement here in this text. It's pretty engaging. So thank you again, Joe, for the inspiration. I had a lot of fun working on this today. I hope that if everyone out there likes this video, please give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel or PowerPoint tutorials. So I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.